In this tutorial, we're going to start with monthly sales data for the imaginary store captured in Microsoft Excel table and see if there is any correlation between monthly sales and outdoor temperature. Our goal is to find out if people shop less during the winter month when the weather is colder and if the changes in sales can be explained by changes in outdoor temperature. To complete this task, we will be creating Microsoft Excel combo chart with secondary access.
Hi there, this is Vadim Michalenko from Stunning Professional Presentations, where we teach you how to use different tools to create awesome business presentations. Let's first take a look at the final version of the document to see how it might be relevant to what you're trying to accomplish.
In this tutorial, we're going to create Excel combo chart with secondary access by looking at specific business problem. We're going to look at the sales history to see if we can find the pattern between sales and outdoor temperature for the store.
I wanted to mention that this video is the part of the multi-video series where we teach you how to take the document and make it ready for the business presentation, which could be shared with the business leaders. So make sure to look in the description of this video to find the links to the remaining parts of this tutorial.
We start with Microsoft Excel data, then create chart with secondary access in Excel, then add 3D effects to the chart. Then in the second tutorial, we create an additional line graph on a secondary access chart. And then in the last tutorial, we take created chart into PowerPoint and create animations for professional presentation. Links to all the tutorials and downloads are available in the description of the video. Make sure to check them out. And all the best on your project. So let's go ahead and start with our featured tutorial. First, let's look at the source data that we have in Excel. In the first column, we have month, January through December. In the second column, we have sales for our imaginary store in dollars. And then in the third column, we have temperature in Fahrenheit, annual temperature, average temperature per month. Our goal is to create a clear chart that would show potential correlation between sales and outdoor temperature that would be useful for professional presentation. Through our initial check of the data, we see that all the data required to generate combo chart in Excel is present. We have both sales data and temperature fully populated in the Excel table. Let's go to the next step and create combo chart in Microsoft Excel. Combo chart is used to highlight the different types of information. It can be used when you have a range of values of chart varies widely and you have a mixed data types, which is true in our case because if you look at the data ranges, sales are in thousands and temperature in a single or double digits. So we need something to highlight and have different values on both axes. As a next step, let's click Insert, Combo, Clustered Column, Line and Secondary Axis Chart. And this chart highlights the different types of information as I already mentioned. To insert this chart successfully, you need to make sure all the source data is selected before you click Insert. As you can see, the chart that was inserted looks very plain and requires some editing. So let's make this chart look professional so it could be used for professional presentation. First, we're going to change the title for the chart so it represents all the information we're trying to communicate.
Are you enjoying this episode? Make sure to subscribe so you're not missing the next one and tell your friends about it so they will learn more skills in the area. Now let's continue and have more fun.
In the next step, we're going to make the line thicker by changing the width of the line. We're going to go to Properties, select the width, and change width for the line to 7 points. In the next step, we're going to add line markers. To do that, we're going to go to Properties for the marker, and we're going to select built-in circle marker, and we're going to pick the size of 17 for the marker. in the next step, we're gonna make marker three-dimensional. We're gonna go to Properties, Effects, to Bevel, and select the value from the drop-down box. And then in the following step, we're gonna select Material, and we're gonna select Special Effects Material. This concludes building of the chart. Now you can take the final document and copy and paste it to different places where you need it for presentation. Let's spend a few moments and look at the chart to see if we can answer the business question. If you remember correctly, our question was, is there a correlation between sales volumes and outdoor temperature? Are there fewer people shopping in the winter month? And the answer is yes, absolutely. There are fewer people shopping in the winter months. But increase in temperature does not explain everything, because there are still variations in sales even during the summer months and other warmer months. So there is something else that's missing in this chart, and that's what we're going to look in the second tutorial. So make sure to find it on YouTube by looking in the description of this video. In our next tutorial, we're going to look at the impact of discounts that store initiated and see what kind of impact did they have on sales.
Just a quick reminder that this video is a part of the multi-video series where we teach you how to take the data, analyze it, format it, and prepare for the business presentation. This presentation could later be shared with the business leaders. So make sure to look in the description of the video to find the remaining pieces of the puzzle and look at the entire video series to accomplish your goals. Have you enjoyed this episode? Make sure to subscribe so you will not miss the next one, and tell your friends about it. Thanks for watching. Hope you've learned something and enjoyed this video. If you can, please share this information with somebody who might be working on the presentation right now and will benefit from this tutorial. Also, please share your comments and thoughts in the comment sections down below. I really review all of them and respond if opportunity permits, and of course if I know the answer. Also, if you like this video, please click that like button right there. This really helps me with my rankings. You can find links and downloads in the description section of this video. There are a lot of helpful links and a lot of other helpful information you will benefit from.
Make sure to check out my other relevant videos and subscribe to my YouTube channel. We have a lot of great stuff planned in the pipeline, and I don't want you to miss any of it. And if you'd like to get notified about all the new stuff that are coming out, make sure to subscribe to my email list as well. All links are here on the screen. Make sure to click to stay in touch. Thanks again for watching.